Squad! What's up? Pino E here, and I've got a ton of stuff to cover today, but first let's take a look at tomorrow's drops and let's get straight into it. The Adidas Ultraboost 3.0 makes its appearance tomorrow in a black and white colorway and a triple white colorway. Retail price for both pairs is $180 each, and they can be found on adidas.com and select Adidas Originals retailers. And I doubt any of you need a reminder, but also releasing tomorrow are the Adidas Ultraboost Triple Black. Retail price on these is also $180. And last up, self-lacing sneakers finally arrive tomorrow when the HyperAdapt releases for $720. Just a couple things before we move on. Release links for all three pairs of the Adidas will be in the description, and sorry, but their release time is random, so I don't know when they're dropping. New Balance released another pair today as part of their holiday collection. The New Balance Tempest Grey Gum features a full grey perforated premium suede upper with a rubber gum bottom. Good quality, and it's a cool chill shoe. You can find them today at select New Balance retailers for $80. So this next pair is kind of wild. The Midas Sneakers ASICS G2 Squirrel released back in October exclusive to Midas, but it's making its way to Europe on Saturday. The quarter panels and eye stay of the shoe are covered in a dark hazelnut colorway, while the toe box, heel tab, and lateral ASICS logo come in a chestnut. The medial side of the shoe features the ASICS logo in the Midas Classic blue and red, and it all sits on a cream and chestnut mid and outsole. Let's switch to Adidas, and first up, the NMD R2 is releasing on December 3rd, and I thought this video Adidas Originals posted of the R1 transforming to the R2 was kind of cool, so here it is. Last up for Adidas, we have a new limited shoe only available at Miami's Art Basel. This limited edition Adidas EQT Support AVD Art Basel is limited to 1,000 pairs, and it features an all-white upper, reflective three stripes, and Art Basel branding on the tongue. These won't be available for sale, but will be a giveaway for those in the Miami area, but one pair will be given away through the Adidas Originals Facebook page, so make sure you stay tuned in over there. Over to Nike, and we got another treat for anyone in Miami. The Nike Air Force One Low Linen is releasing exclusive to Kith Miami. The store will hold a raffle for pairs on four separate days, and the first day falls on December 2nd. And according to Kith, pairs will be available in size 8 to 13, and they're going to be made from the original material used on the 2001 pairs. Good luck! It's funny how a shoe can bring back memories and bring you to a certain point in your life, and what we have up on the screen are probably my favorite Air Max of all time, the Air Max 97 Silver Bullet. It comes dressed in a metallic silver, varsity red, white, and black colorway, and it features 3M on the upper's piping. Dubbed La Silver as a tribute to its ties to Italy, this pair is releasing in Italy on December 2nd, with a wider release to Western Europe on December 14th for $175. There's no word on when these will drop in North America yet, but with next year being the 20th anniversary of the model, it shouldn't be too long. We got more official pictures from Nike, and this time it's the Nike Air More Uptempo Reflective. This pair comes dressed completely blacked out with 3M accenting around the letters spelling out Air, 3M on the laces, and a black outsole. There's no official word on release date or pricing yet, so stay tuned. Up next, the Nike Kyrie 2 What The. I'm not really going to explain this shoe much because I don't really understand what's going on here myself. Looking at it, we could see a wild sock liner and different elements from other pairs of the two, but what confuses me is the green color. A couple or maybe a few weeks back, Nike gave us two official picks, one in white and one in green. So why is this shoe green, or why does the official pick also have white? I don't know. Does it change color? Are there two pairs? No idea. Guess we gotta wait and see. And last up for Nike, the triple white Nike Special Forces Air Force One. We got a release date, and these are dropping on December 8th, and I expect the hype to be real. Unfortunately, at this time, I don't have release locations. I do expect that they will drop on the Sneakers app, but stay tuned, and I'll make sure to keep you all updated. Over to Jordan Brand, and first up, I think the story is cool, but boy, would I be pissed. We have a candidate for Teacher of the Year, and it's the teacher that decided to give his student this pair of OG Chicago Ones. According to the person who received them, the teacher noticed the student was a fan of sneakers and gave him his son's OG pair. Nice come up, but what would you do if your parents gave these away? I haven't really been a fan of the Mellow line, but for those of you that are, here's a first look at the Jordan Mellow 13. Honestly, not even sure how to explain this one. The toe box is fused to a really unique looking upper, which has a diamond pattern textile sticking out. Anyway, no release info on these for now, but the model should be making its debut soon. Today, Jordan Brand gave us an official look at the Air Jordan 11 Monster Mash. Yes, these are called Monster Mash, and I don't like the name, so I'm going to keep calling them the Space Jams. The Space Jam 11s will be releasing in full family sizes on December 10th, and the pricing's as follows. Crib will release for $55, toddlers will be available for $70, preschool pricing is $90, grade school retail is $170, and the men's will be releasing for $220. We got another first look today, and up on the screen are the Air Jordan 4 Motorsport. The shoe comes in a white leather upper with varsity blue and black detailing, and unfortunately, the Mars Blackmon will not be on the heel when these release on March 26th for $190. And speaking of heels, how about Nike Air on the heel of the Air Jordan 4 Bred? So before I go any further, this comes from a friend and a very good source who I'm not going to name, but I've known him for a couple years and he hasn't been wrong yet, so I trust this. What we don't know is the release date, although there is a chance we might be seeing these on Black Friday. Anyway, that's what I know for now, so I just wanted to share it with you all and stay tuned for more info. So I finished recording this and Adidas just gave away the Art Basel exclusive, so I just wanted to update you all. Anyway, that's the end of today's video. If you enjoyed it, and I hope you did, hit that like button. If you're new around here, subscribe, join the squad. If you have something to say, leave it in the comments below. And I'm out.